Yo, what is going on, everybody? Carnage back here again, and I have a pretty exciting haul for you. I've picked up a few things, a couple of things I do not have with me, but I will tell you what they are. But first, I'm gonna start off with the I'll start off with the comic books that I got. So, just gotta move these figures out of the way, and starting off with this, some of these are kind of ones that I have shown before. I just have them right next to me just because it's a pile of comics that I need to read still. And as you can see, I've gotten a pretty thick amount. And yes, I am going to use the word thick because it's the perfect word for this. And yeah. And I have a little secret at the end. Well, it's a secret to me, but it's mainly because it's the most coolest thing, in my opinion. And I believe one of them is still, yep. And anyway, starting off, this was from a couple of weeks, or last week, I mean. And that is, I don't remember if I put this one in a video, but I got Avengers Empire number 0, or number 1, I mean. Oh no, this is Empire number 1, my apologies. Anyway, I have Empire number 1. So far, I really do enjoy the story. It's pretty good so far. I then also have Fantastic Four Empire number 0. And again, I was kind of a little skeptical, like I was going to just gonna pick up the first few issues, you know, and I thought it was pretty good after I read it was like a prelude to it or something like that. I'm not fully positive what the issue is. I know I have it in a pile, but yeah. And I also got Emperor Hulking, and this is also part of Empire, and this is Empire the Avengers number 1, I believe. Yeah, number 1. And haven't read either of these yet either, but I'm pretty excited to, because this is actually starting to become one of my favorite series that I've read so far in comic book form. Sorry, just moving some stuff off my lap. Okay. This one is one I actually really enjoyed. This is The Immortal Hulk issue number 35. And it's pretty good. I really like it so far. Like, it's an amazing series, so if you have not read it, I really, really recommend it. And I just remembered, I don't remember if I showed off any in this pile. I don't believe I have. No, I have not. This is actually a little pile I forgot about, almost. And, yeah. And these came from my stepdad. He went to Colorado with my stepsister because she recently graduated. So, congratulations to my stepsister. And he picked me up 3 comic books. And the first one was The Incredible Hulk, issue number 443. He also picked up Wolverine Origins, number 7. And this has Omega Red and Maverick? I think Maverick, it might not be Maverick, but anyway, Omega Red and Wolverine. It's a pretty cool cover. I would have picked this up if I won with them. And he did get me a double by accident, but I mean, I still appreciate the thought about it. He picked me up Deadpool issue number 2, and I don't know whose run this is. Like, I'm not fully into comic books to where I know that kind of stuff, but it was really nice of him. And I know I mentioned Empire number 0 earlier, and here, or Avengers Empire number 0, and this one actually makes the most sense for, like, the whole story to me, just because I need to, like, know what happens beforehand and stuff like that. That's just my brain. Sorry, I kind of rambled. But anyway, this one I was really happy to get, and my dad picked this one up for me along with Another one. I believe it was Fantastic Four Empire. I believe it was that one. But he also got me Marvel's X. And I really love this series. And I'm really excited for issue 5. I mean, just... these usually tell you what the cover is going to look like next. And the cover is going to have Captain America on it. And I know I'm already going to like it because I'm really enjoying Marvel's X. Especially issue number 2. I really enjoyed issue number 2 the most out of... them. And this one I picked up on, today is Thursday the 23rd, so I picked this one up last Sunday, and I only picked it up because I really liked how the cover looked with Two-Face and Deathstroke. Like, I haven't seen a comic book cover this cool in a long time, so I may start picking up more DC comics. And I don't know if you guys can see that, like, this is a little off topic, but yeah, I slammed my chin at the bottom of a pool, and I'm perfectly fine. It bled a little bit, but I'm fine. And then these two are two DC comics, and this one is Dark Knight's Death Metal number 2. And yes, I have to do Death Metal every time I do it, so when I get issue 3 of Death Metal, expect that when it comes up. But yeah, pretty good series so far. Especially like how it starts off, in my opinion. Like, it has a mixture of Batman and the Atom. And he literally calls himself Batom. And it's amazing. And it's something that a child would think of. And it's just perfect. And this is actually a series that I haven't read any issue before. I mainly picked it up because I know it's going to be like a really big thing, and I didn't really have a whole lot of Batman or Joker comics, anything like that. But I got issue number 5 of the brand new Batman, or not brand new since it's almost at issue 100. Anyway, issue number 95 of Batman, and this is part 1 of the Joker War. And I really liked all the covers, but this one looked to me better than the rest of them. And this is, and these are the ones I'm really excited about that I'm gonna save for the end, even after I show all the figures I got. And then I got Wolverine issue number 3 from the new Wolverine run, and this is a Marvel Zombies variant. The reason why I got the variant is because I really like the Marvel Zombies concept, the whole deceased concept, everything like that. Just, it's an amazing thing in my opinion. And now for the Marvel Legends. Okay, my day started off with me going to a GameStop at my local mall, and I found the Dark Beast, and they were having like a, like a percent off. I don't remember how much. I think it was like either 5 to 10% off, maybe even 20% off of any action figures they had. And they had him. He was the only one from the Age of Apocalypse wave. And the guy said that they had put him out like maybe not that long before I showed up. So I was pretty happy when that happened. And then I went to a Walmart after that, and I found, like, most of the figures from the X-Men, the Age of Apocalypse X-Men wave, except for one of them. Yeah, and I picked up Sunspot, Jean Grey, Wild Child, and Weapon X. And you might be thinking, wait, he spent $80 at Walmart? Correction. They were having, like, a sale on them, where they were doing, like, them for $11. Let me just... come on. Focus, focus. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it says $11 each for all of those figures. So that was an amazing deal. Like, not even amazing, that was perfect. And this is a newer wave, too. Well, not really new, but it's new enough to where you would think, that they wouldn't be going on clearance quite yet. And fun fact about the Walmart where I got these, that's where I found the Shang-Chi figure. And I was really happy about that when I found him too. But that's basically what I got for figures yesterday. And now my Sugar Man wave is basically complete. I just need to find, what's his name? X-Man? I just need him, and then I have the whole wave. And I do have Morph, I just have not put the leg on yet. Because I was just really excited and wanted to show you guys. And I got all of this yesterday. Aside from, like, some of the comic books where I got them from, like, the past couple of weeks. And now for the stuff I am really excited to show you guys. I found deceased comic books and from, like, the original run, too. So I'm really, really happy about that. So I got issue number 2. And I just really love this series. It's an amazing series, in my opinion. I also found issue number 4, and this is, like, the normal cover. This one's, like, a variant cover. I don't know which number variant it is. Like, I know they have, like, A, B, C, D, stuff like that. If you hear snoring, my dog's kind of there. And this is one my dad picked up when I had to work and I couldn't go to the comic shop, and I had a feeling this one would sell out. And from what I saw, it kind of did, and that was Deceased Dead Planet. And this one takes place after everything that happened in the normal storyline, slash A Good Day to Die, and Deceased Unkillables, which, by far, Unkillables, still my favorite one. So, my dad got me that. And then this comic, I was really, really thrilled I found. Like, beyond thrilled, actually. And that was Deceased issue number 1. And this is, like, the normal cover variant. And I would have really liked to see the, like, variant that kind of, like, looks a little bit like the Deadshot one. Or not Deadshot, Deathstroke comic I got. Where, just like that art style. But, I mean, issue number 1, and it does have, like, a little bit of a weird, like, print issue right up there, but that's not a big deal to me. I'm just really happy I found this. So, I am basically, have the whole run except for about 1, 2, 3, except for about 5 issues. I have the entire Deceased thing, all first print. Or, all, like, newer. I mean, Deceased came out in, like, October, I believe. But, anyway, yeah, that's basically it for, excuse me. That's basically it for my haul this week. Even though I think I posted my last video a few days ago. Not fully positive about that, but I think that's when it was. Anyway, yeah, thank you all for watching. Sorry about all the rambling as I normally do. I don't mean to, I just kind of think about different things at different points. Because ADD. ADD. Which is attention deficit disorder. Again, going off, rambling, sorry. But anyway, I really do appreciate every single one of you watching my videos. And as always, be nice to each other, and peace out.